Today is your day. Your time is now. Take control of your life today. Those are common day worldly mantras and self-esteem encouragements that you've probably heard from hundreds of places. Jesus had something similar to say, but I'm fairly certain it didn't mean what our gurus of today mean. Jesus and his brothers are talking about when the right time is for Jesus to go into Jerusalem for a special feast. Jesus says that it's not the right time, like his brothers suggest it is. And then he says this strange word. John chapter 7, verse 6, "My time has not yet come, but your time is always here." Here's what we learn. The appearance and influence of Jesus' brothers in Jerusalem was of no consequence to the world because they themselves were of the world. Nothing of eternal significance hangs on their movements. The world will not hate them. They have no righteous influence, no eternally significant influence on the world because, well, they're of the world. When you're walking in the ways of the world, it doesn't really matter when you do what you do. But we love this text because of Jesus and his determination to only listen to his Father's voice. Because of this, Jesus' movements and timing are of eternal significance, which means they are significant for us. And we live this out by realizing that our lives take on eternal significance when we too live according to God's mission. Anything less is, well, of eternal insignificance. So don't buy into the mantra of today is your day, your time is now, unless, of course, you're making today the day you get on board with God's plans. As you pray today, please remember Joe and Myra Costa, our missionaries in Lebanon. And also remember the Hungarian Life Word broadcast heard throughout Hungary.